Thank you. This is subject 12-19-86-23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, assisted by Dr. Williams, and in the lab itself, our volunteer, Mr. Asian.
We have artifact 23 in the chamber, recovered from crash site B.
At the moment, it appears inert, showing no signs of activity. Mr. Asian, instructions for each stage will come through to your terminal, and we need you to follow them exactly. Now, some of this may be unfamiliar, so always reference the manual on your terminal for guides on calibration and procedure. Once you've calibrated equipment to match our brief, the green light will flash, allowing you to trigger the experiment. One last thing. Ensure that any equipment non-essential to the current experiment is switched off. You cannot proceed until your calibration matches ours. When you're ready, let's bring this back. Okay, good work. The x-ray is coming through now. There's no visible damage to the surrounding organic material, and no signs of activity either. All output is flatlined. Okay, let's begin. No reaction from first stage. Let's try high frequency. Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again. Seems we have a pulse. Rhythm is stable, there's no activity registering in the core. It's possibly damaged. Let's push further.
not much of a response. Updating the experiment now. Seeing some fluctuations in activity.
Should we increase? Do the risk of damage?
What about a volunteer? Okay, we're gonna push further. I'm running out of time. Let's switch around. Seeing good activity on this side, seeing definite spikes in movement. I know this might seem uncomfortable or dangerous, but you need to trust us and keep going. Full activity registering. We did it.
Can you hear us?
You've made excellent progress. You're doing great. Now we need you to stay calm and try to relax as we go through these next steps. We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort. Feel. Don't be scared. We have the situation under control. Take a few moments, and when you're ready, we'll continue. Remember. proxy now. You have a connection to the entity's inner core. It's like a conscious black box. It can show you its memories. Look into it. The visions will translate onto the screen to be something that you can understand, that you can play out.
Please understand it was for the greater good.
We had to know more. Rebelling now could be catastrophic. You don't know what this might do to you in the long run. This will haunt you.
Station 3, do you read me? Give me a sign, man. This storm is getting pretty wild. Come on, 3, log in. Quit fucking around.
There he is.
Finally! What took you?
Is the microphone still broken in Station 3? I'll take that as a yes.
Yeah, you can't reply. You should be able to hear you, though. Can see activity registering, so your voice is definitely going through.
Oh, okay. We can chat later, 3.
Yeah, this is pretty serious. I've had a distress call from Central. There's a situation and we have to fire up signal monitoring and relay systems right away.
What kind of situation?
I don't know. I'm assuming it's got something to do with this storm. Whatever it is, it's big to want to involve us.
Shit. Okay, what do we do then?
Well, my fucking cabin power isn't holding up in this weather, so I can't process the signals myself. 2, you need to feed the frequency information through to the backup terminal in Station 3. And 3, you just need to tune, decode, and process. Just refer to the handbook on the microfilm. It'll walk you through it.
I've never done any of this stuff, so I'm not going to be much help, I'm afraid.
It's simple, honestly. You could do this in your sleep.
Okay, first one is due to appear in a minute or so. Have a quick read of that microfilm handbook. It should be on your left.
I'm going to get suited up and restart the generator. Don't fuck it up.
Okay, 3, we're up. Do whatever it is you're supposed to do. Okay, my light here just turned green and the signal stopped. So I think you did it right. Next one coming up in 30 seconds, apparently.
Don't leave them hanging too long. I don't know what they're for, but I know we have to make them top priority or I'll get shit.
Of course, don't worry, we'll keep on top of it. Okay, there it is. Creepy sounding things, aren't they? Tank 3, just pushing this update to the transmitter now. Getting the hang of it, huh? Next one coming up. One, what does GCS mean?
GCS? What do you mean?
Yeah, no, this next one has come through with an additional note. GCS 3 equals E1 V1 M1.
I've not seen it before. Check the microfilm. Might be something in there about it. Listen, let me know when you're done with that one. I haven't heard back from the transport team and I'm starting to worry.
Sure thing. Okay, here it is. Whoa. Okay, that's different.
Flashing red screen.
Yeah, quite the warning sign.
Shit. Something's going on. The last two must have just been testing the system. Tune it as normal and I'll see what I can find out once I get these goddamn lights on.
Okay, one, we're done. Nothing has happened really, all good. What did you want?
I'm about to head outside to look at this generator. My cabin is completely out. Listen, I just checked the roster and we were supposed to hear from the supply team 3 days ago. But I've had nothing. No responses either.
Shit. The storm?
I hope not. Three, can you monitor a range for me? They use an emergency signal somewhere between 8,000 and 8,500 range. FM. See if you can track it down for me.
That's our supplies for the next 6 months. If they turn back, what do we do?
We can reschedule. I'm more worried that they didn't turn back. Otherwise, we'd be having a drink by now. The boat was called 20F.
God, yeah. Okay. Three. 8,500 FM somewhere. See if you can pick up a distress signal or something. Oh my god, that's them.
This is a distress signal from supply vessel 20F. Please respond. Is anyone there? We don't have enough supplies to last whatever this is out. We have some on board, but it's not enough. We try to turn back, but the storm, or them, have messed with our GPS and sent us straight into the ice.
What on earth is he talking about?
We're holed up here. We just got word from Central that New York has fallen. Everyone's gone there now. I thought us being so remote would give us time, maybe, but I can see it coming. Be ready, all of you. It's 20F up.
One, are you there? Are you hearing this?
Lock your door, too. Three, do the same.
What do you mean? Did you hear the report?
I just got a call from Station B at the coast. Something is happening. I don't know what, but they said we had to lock up and stay in our cabins. Then it went dead.
What are you talking about?
Just do it. They're here.
Ugh! Who are they? Shit, one, there's another GCS signal coming in. Do we process it still?
Yeah. As long as the GCS number is going up, we're helping a lot of people.
It was 3 last time. It's 6 this time. What does it mean?
That's good. That's good. Just process the signals.
That's it in. There's something. I don't know what I'm looking at. Cabling? 1, I can see something above 3's cabin. 1 of the power lines down. 1, are you there?
Fuck! What the hell is that?
I can't see you from here, 1. What's going on?
It's above me. Shit, it's above me. It's over station 3 too. They're here.
What's here? Jesus, 1, what the fuck is out there?
It's fine. It's fine, you'll be fine.
Shit, here's another signal. GCS7 equals E1 V5 M1. 1, what the hell? It's flashing urgent.
Guys, are any of you walking around in that storm? That's crazy. You'll get yourself killed.
No one is outside. You're seeing things, 4.
James, the last signal hasn't sent. My terminal is going crazy demanding a response. I think the wind has misaligned a transmitter or something. We need to go out to it. Please, James, I'm sorry, but I can't get out. I'm trapped. You'll still be able to hear me, though. Go. Go.
He's coming back.
That's enough of that for now. You're quite fond of this show, aren't you? Okay, come on. Let's get you down to the observation room. This place must be starting to feel like home to you. Don't worry. I'll try and get you out of here eventually. I'm just in here. Okay, are we through in the next room? Just relax and we'll get started in a moment.
Right, Mr. Asian, now are you ready? Just hit record on the tape deck in front of you when you're ready. This is subject 12-19-86-23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, and in a room we have our patient, Mr. James Asian. As we know, James has recently recovered from a 2-week coma following his accident. In our last 3 sessions, James's attempts to recollect events of the accident seen him merging his memory with his imagination. These episodes have always ended in panic, and we've had to terminate the session abruptly. Let's try and do this one better, James. So when you're ready, let's bring this back. I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this. James, it's time to remember. Your mind, it's like a conscious black box. It can show you your memories. Look into it. Recent episode, you recalled a false memory of a remote weather station. You were isolated from the rest of the world, locked inside your coma. We interacted with you daily, encouraging you to wake. Your family would do number puzzles with you, anything really to bring you back. People needed answers, James. Do you remember?
I have another signal here for you, James. It's at 5610 FM. You can't miss it. Find the signal, James. Listen to the voices. You have to face it, James. Finally.
Not like him at all. I've worked with Officer Hennings for 6 years and not once have we even talked about alcohol. Drunk driving. He was a father, a husband. He was fine. No way he caused this. It's him. This Haitian guy. He's got something to hide.
He has quite an imagination, Mr. Haitian. I guess it's from the shows he's been watching. This time he described an A&E visit as a government conspiracy or some sort of plan. It's interesting stuff, and it's obviously pure fiction. But I guess it's just his way of coping for now. We'll see how we progress in future sessions.
We found him lying there sobbing while his sister died in the car next to him. While Hennings died next to him. What the fuck was he thinking? She was still alive when we got to her. If he'd have done something, they could all still be here.
Today was the first session with Mr. James Haitian, although I fear it will certainly not be his last. When asked about events that have happened in the past, he confused fact and fiction and told us a story about a computer game that was talking to him. I think he was back at his own house, his mum and dad's house, and he always talked about a room with a red X, one he couldn't get in. I don't know what any of this means or what it's going to do with the accident, but I guess some more sessions will maybe reveal that. We're going to try again tomorrow.
You honestly believe that Hennings was drunk at the wheel and not this little shit? If he wakes up, when he wakes up, I want answers. Until then, you handle it. You write it up. I'm out.
Okay, we have a 22-year-old male just brought in from a vehicle collision. He was awake and mobile at the scene, but collapsed on arrival to the emergency ward. The other passengers died in the accident. I'm getting no pulse. Prepare for defib. Amp charge full to 10 and give me 100 joules. Come on, 100 joules. Charging amp full to 10. Come on.
Come on, 100 clear. Joules. Charging up full to 10. No reaction from first stage. Let's try higher. 200 joules. Keep the amp charged at 10. Keep the charge at 10. Let's go. 200 joules. Keep the charge at 10. Let's go.
5. Clear.
Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again. 360, charge full. 360, hurry.
5. Clear.
Well, would you look at that? It seems we have a pulse. Rhythm is stable. We need to run an x-ray right away. Where are we with that x-ray? Let's get it going now, please. Can we get this on the screen, please? Looks like an intracerebral hemorrhage. We need to drain this now to relieve pressure. Prepare for trepanation. Switch on a drill, please. Drill, please. Mr. Asian, you've made excellent progress. You're doing great. We need you to stay calm and try to relax while we go through these next steps. We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
Sorry, I don't understand.
We tried our best, Mrs. Asian, but her injuries were too severe.
No, I don't understand. I was just talking to her.
I'm afraid Jennifer passed away before we could get to her in surgery. We did the best we could. I am so sorry.
Where is she? Let me see her.
Please, Mrs. Asian, take a seat.
I don't want to take a seat. Let me talk to her. Now.
I'll arrange for you to see her. In the meantime, James is in recovery. He's stable for now.
I don't want to see him.
You're all over the place, James. Pull over. James, for fuck's sake, pull over! James!
It was at this very moment, wasn't it, James? The moment you lost it all. Your sister. Your parents. Yourself. And then you made it worse. Go on. Show us what you did.
Yourself apart over it, but no matter what you keep telling yourself, you have to listen to me. That accident, that poor man, me, you have to remember. It was all your fault. I know what you did, how you left me there to protect yourself. Planting evidence on some poor man. You went headfirst into that officer and you wrecked all of our lives. And then you couldn't even take responsibility. You did the right thing for you and no one else. Save yourself. Only it was wrong, wasn't it? Look at me now. Utterly consumed by it. Say it, James.
Well, I think we've made progress today, Mr. Asian. I guess we should tell the police what you've told us. Although I don't suspect it'll take you anywhere. I think you'll be with us for quite some time. Come on, let's get you back to your shows. I'll see you tomorrow.